let's understand lessee accounting in a way that makes sense. Your business needs a Boeing 737 for 3 years. Now, it doesn't make sense to purchase a huge asset, an airplane, just for 3 years. So you choose to lease it instead. You have to make a payment of $100 at the end of every year for 3 years. The question is, how should we account for this transaction in accordance with IFRS 16? Now, before IFRS 16, we had to decide whether a lease is a finance lease or an operating lease for both the lessee and the lessor. But under IFRS 16, a lessee has to treat all leases as finance lease. They get no operating lease except for low value items and leases with a term of less than 1 year. Now, that's a drastic change which results in the recognition of right of use asset for almost all leases in the books of the lessee, which means I'm required to recognize an asset which I literally do not own. Why does it make sense? Let's say these Apple slices represent the remaining useful lives of an airplane. If you count these slices, these are 5, because in our example, the remaining useful life for the airplane is 5 years. Now, your company is only obtaining it on lease for the next 3 years, which means you're entering into an agreement to eat the 3 slices but return the remaining 2. Although you haven't purchased the asset, you have in essence purchased the 3 years life of that asset. Now, this analogy only works if you are reasonably certain to make those payments to the lessor. Which means if you are reasonably certain to contractually make those payments, you are in effect having a liability to make those payments, and it should be reflected in your financial statements to communicate that to your shareholders. But that lease liability is incurred to obtain something, and that is a benefit that will be utilized over the next 3 years, which means it cannot be expensed out, it has to be an asset. So coming back to the transaction in our example, the lease of Boeing 737 for $100 every year, how should we account for it? One is obtaining of a loan, and the second is purchase of the asset. Now, normally, if you would obtain a loan, we would create the liability and debit the bank. And normally, when we would purchase an asset, we would debit the asset and credit the bank. But in this case, in case of a lease transaction, the bank is not involved. Like, we do not receive cash when we incur a liability. Similarly, we do not pay actual cash when we purchase the asset. Rather, we are incurring a liability against the asset directly. So the bank is knocked off, and initial recognition accounting entry is simply the debit of right of use asset and credit of the lease liability. Now let's just zoom into the lease liability component of the transaction. So this commitment to make a $100 payment at the end of each year is an obligation with a predetermined timing and amount, which makes it hardly any different than a loan, as we just discussed. According to IFRS 16, we would recognize the present value of all the lease payments as our lease liability. Why would we not recognize the full $300 as a lease liability? Because it's more than 1 year and there's a financing component involved. And that financing component has to be discounted to come up with the amount of liability. Now, the discount rate used is normally the interest rate implicit in the lease. And if that is not available, it is the lessee's incremental borrowing rate of interest. Now, what these rates are, we'll not go into that technicality in this video. We'll have some different videos for that. For now, our discount rate is 5%. Based on this discount rate, the $100 payment we have to make at the end of year one is worth $95.2 today. The $100 payment we have to make at the end of year two is worth $90.7 today. And the $100 payment for year three is worth $86.4 today. The total principal amount we owe to them is the sum of the present value of all the three payments, which is $272.3. So we create the lease liability by $272.3 at initial recognition. But by what amount should we debit the right of use asset? And that's a little technical, because perhaps we are not only incurring the lease liability to obtain that asset, but maybe we have made some other expenditures as well. So in addition to the lease liability, the value of the right of use asset would also include any lease payments made at or before the commencement date, because there's the amount paid for the right of use asset but not captured in the lease liability. any initial direct costs incurred by the lessee, again for similar reasons, if there have been any initial direct costs incurred by the lessee, this has not been captured in the lease liability, and therefore the cost of the asset will increase by that. And thirdly, any provision for dismantling costs. Now, when we recognize the provision for dismantling of an asset, we create the provision and we do not debit the expense, rather we debit it in the asset account. The reason for this is that the dismantling cost should be spread over the useful life of the asset and should not be expensed out all at once. Now, this treatment is not just for right of use asset. The dismantling cost is added to any property, plant, and equipment asset that is purchased. So let's say, in addition to the lease liability, we have also made an advance payment of $50 at the start of the lease, which means a right of use asset would be recognized at the amount of lease liability, which is $270.3, plus the amount that is $50, and this would make it $322.3. So we create a liability by $270.3, we debit the right of use asset by $322.3. We have a difference of $50, which we actually paid from bank, so we traded the bank by $50. So that was the initial recognition of right of use asset and lease liability. Finally, we have subsequently account for the lease liability, the repayment of lease liability, and we also have to subsequently account for the depreciation of the right of use asset. And we will discuss these as separate videos. I hope you found this video interesting, enjoyable, and easy. Please do let me know your thoughts in the comments. It really matters a lot.